everyone, welcome to the Little Gym at Home. I know this is a little bit different from what we're used to, but trust me when I say me and the rest of our team at the Little Gym of Sugarland miss all of you in our classes and being on our big red mat. So I am so excited that we get to take a class from home today. I'm so excited that you guys are staying home and you're being safe and staying healthy, just like I'm staying home and being safe and staying healthy too. Because remember, our number one rule at the Little Gym is to be safe. But of course, our second rule is to have fun. And we are going to have a lot of fun today, you guys. Speaking of fun, I wanted to show you our sign for today. We've practiced this before, but it looks like this. Fun. Can you guys try that? Fun. We're going to have lots and lots of fun here at the Little Gym at Home today. So, if you don't know me, my name is Miss Delaney. Hi. I'm sure you guys are waving back at me, even though I can't see you. Can you wave or maybe give me a high five? High five. All right, parents, before we get started today, I wanted to tell you a few tools and equipment that we may need today in our class. So you may see that I'm on a yoga mat. You don't have to have a yoga mat. I just wanted to because I've got hard floors and I want to be safe. So I wanted to put my yoga mat down so that I could demonstrate some skills for you guys on our yoga mat. So you guys can find a space in your house that has plenty of room. Even if it's not that big, that's okay. You can see that I don't have much of a large space right here, but I'm going to make it work and I'm so excited. I've also got two sticks. So if you guys have ever been to one of our classes at the Little Gym, you know that we incorporate sticks a lot. We're going to do some tapping today. I'm using chopsticks. Some other things you guys could use are maybe wooden utensils or spoons. Or even if you've got plastic ones, those would be safe. We just don't want to hurt ourselves. Or maybe some paper towel tubes. You know, those little brown tubes. You guys could use those for your sticks. I also have my assistant here today. This is my little bear that I'm going to use to show you guys how to spot some different skills today. You might have seen my cat over here earlier in the beginning of this video. If he chooses to come back, he might even show us some skills. Who knows? That would be really silly. I also have my bubbles here. So if you guys have bubbles, you guys can incorporate bubbles into the end of our class, just like we normally do at the Little Gym. I don't have my bouncy balls today, but if you guys have any balls of any sort, you are welcome to get those out as well. We're going to be incorporating those in the end too, so that it's just like our classes at the Little Gym. So you guys can take a moment to pause the video if you like, and you can go gather those skills and you can come back, or not skills, you can go gather all of those tools and then you can come back whenever you're ready. See, there's Clover right here. Are you gonna show everybody some skills, Clover? He's not sure what he's getting himself into. All right, everybody. Are you already back from gathering all of your tools? That's awesome. It's time to play our song, okay? Today, instead of using our shakers, we're going to clap. So can you guys all clap with me? Clover, can you clap? All right, everyone. Everyone, please clap your hands and sing along with me. How do you do, everybody? How do you do? How do you do, everybody? How do you do? Oh, you come to gym for fun, and we'll get you on the run. How do you do, everybody? How do you do? Okay, so just a reminder again, our theme today is the Little Gym at Home, and we are going to have lots of fun today. So my name is Miss Delaney. I would love to hear all of your names, okay? So you can tell me your name, or your mom or dad, or whoever you're watching this with can tell us your names, and then make sure, parents, you let us know your name as well. So again, my name is Miss Delaney, and what are your names? Can we get on the furniture? Can we not? Just make sure you guys have a little plan so that we stay safe. Now again, I don't have much of a space to run around, but I'm going to do my best, and I know you guys will too. All right, if you're ready to get started with our warm-up, you can go ahead and stand up wherever you are in your space. I'm going to move my equipment to the side and get our song started. We're gonna start with clapping our hands. You guys ready?
Clap your hands
and stomp your feet. And then can you turn around?
can you walk in a circle? If your child isn't walking on their own, you can help them walk. We can do some assisted walking. Or if they're a bug, ages 4 to 10 months, you can even carry them. Then can you clap your hands again? Can you jump? Let's try to jump. Of course, we can do assisted jumping as well. But you can also show your child how to jump. Make it really big and dramatic because their favorite way of learning is through you, of course. Let's clap our hands. Stomp your feet. And turn around. We're going to wheelbarrow now. Whenever we wheelbarrow, you're going to spot your child in their hips and upper thighs. Their hands are going to reach for the ground while you hold their bottom half up. They're going to support their weight in their hands, their wrists, their shoulders, just like this. So if my bear had his hands on the ground, he would be just like this. They're going to try to bear some weight, and if they even want to walk on their hands, that's okay too. You can pretend he's walking. They're going to wheel there everywhere. Good job. Stomp your feet. And turn around. Can you go upside down? There are plenty of different ways to go upside down. If you want to spot your child in the hips again, they can do a supported handstand just like this. Or if you want to hold them to your chest and drop them down. And let's stomp our feet. Turn around. Let's do some rolls. If you have plenty of room and you can do a forward roll in your room, then go ahead. If not, let's try some long rolls. We're going to get on the floor and roll. Clap your hands. Let's do some assisted sit-ups. You're going to hold your child's hand, help them sit all the way up, use those ab muscles, high over, just like this. Maybe they can even do it on their own almost. We're going to use those core muscles, everyone. You can let them hold your hand and do some sit-ups. Or you can walk or do some assisted walking again. Great job with the warm up, everyone. It's time for our group activity where we're going to use our sticks. So if you haven't gone to find your sticks or your tools that you're using as sticks, go ahead and go grab those. I'm going to set up our music and then we're going to go ahead and sit down on the floor and get ready to tap our sticks. All right, Clover.
All right, kids. Hold on to the sticks.
So we're going to start by tapping them together first, like this. We're gonna hold them in the air. One, two, three, four, five. Hold them up. Good job, everyone. Now we're gonna tap them on the floor. Under our knees.
One, two, three. Underneath. Where'd they go? Can you try to roll them on the floor? Not like this.
Roll them, we're not through. Roll them on the floor. Make
bunny ears.
Count of two.
One, two.
Make bunny
ears. We're almost done, everyone. Can you tap them quietly?
We're so quiet. Tapping, tapping, we're almost done. Tapping, we're so quiet.
We're going to put them in our lap on the count of one. Ready? One. In our lobby,
much like in class when we go explore, we always practice a few skills. So right now we're going to do three parent-child skills that you guys will do together. We're going to build some strength, develop body and spatial awareness, and we're also going to help develop our vestibular system today. So these are skills that we already did today. We practiced these in our warm-ups, so you guys already had a little bit of a chance to try them, but now we're going to take some time and do them all again with my helper right here, and maybe Clover if he wants to help too. So we'll see. Okay, everyone, our first skill that we are going to practice today are our log rolls, but not just any log roll. We're going to do our partner log rolls. So this is something you guys get to do together. Of course, if your child would like to try a log roll on their own, by all means, help them on their own, let them practice. But first, let's do one together. So you guys are both going to lay down on the floor, or maybe on the bed, or wherever you guys choose to practice this. You're going to hold them close to you like this. Okay, Clover, I need this, buddy. I need this. You guys are gonna lay on the ground, okay? So hold them to your chest. You're going to hold your arms out right here so that you can protect them as you guys roll.
And now we're ready to roll, everyone. So I'm going to lay down on my back first and then roll all the way, and maybe do it back the other way. Roll. And if your child wants to practice it on their own, they can lay on their backs as well. They're going to practice turning over to their stomachs. And of course, you guys can help just a little bit, give them that push if they need it. And then they're gonna practice rolling onto their backs. So then give them a little push if they need it again. And ta-da, that's a log roll. Awesome job with your first skill, everybody. Clap for yourselves. If you would like to pause this video and practice that skill a few more times, go for it. Once you're ready, I'm going to continue on to our next skill. Our next skill is going to be going upside down. So for going upside down, like I mentioned before, there are a few different options. If they're not feeling doing some handstands today, you can go ahead and hold them to your chest, and we're going to dip them upside down. Just go dip and come back up, and dip and come back up. Or you could even do something we like to call curls. So you can hold them horizontally in your arms, bring them down, and up, down, and up. Our third option, of course, is a wheelbarrow or an assisted handstand. So you guys could start in your wheelbarrow position again. So make sure their hands are on the ground. You're spotting in their hips and thighs right here. So their bottom half should be off the floor, just their arms are on the floor. You wanna make sure that they're straight. So whenever we're doing a wheelbarrow, if our arms are bent like this, we aren't using strong muscles, so make sure that their arms are straight like this so that we can develop those muscles correctly. So you guys can practice that, start from a wheelbarrow, and then when they're ready, you guys can lift their hips up a little bit higher into an assisted handstand position, of course, just like this. So those are a few different options. One more thing, maybe if you've got a super beast that has practiced this a lot already, you guys can go ahead and try some donkey kicks so they can practice their beginning handstands on their own. And to do those, they are going to put their hands on the ground, kick their feet up in the air, just a little kick like this, go kick. And I'll do it from the side if you want to watch from the side. We're going to put our hands down. Remember, strong arms, we don't want to bend them. We don't want our heads to touch the ground. Hands down, and do a little shunt. Jump, jump. Maybe try it three times in a row, my super beast. Awesome job. Yes, just like that. Great job, everyone. We've got one more skill to practice. So again, if you want to keep practicing those upside down skills, go ahead and pause this video, and I'll be here waiting for you guys when you're ready to try your third skill. Okay, I think everybody is ready for our third skill now. So, our last thing that we practiced in our warm-up is our sit-ups. So, of course, this is to help develop our core muscles, our back, and even our neck muscles for you guys. So they're going to lay in front of you on their backs. I want you to reach out and grab just their fingers maybe. So try to have as light of a hold as possible because we want them to really be using their own muscles to do this with, of course, your assistance. So feel free to put however much assistance and weight into this as you and your child need. So again, they're going to hold on to your fingers and you're going to help them do a sit up and back down, and then sit up and back down. And you guys can practice this however many times you want, okay? Up and down, just like that. Those are our three skills, you guys. Good job, that was awesome. It's like you're right here in the gym with us. So give yourselves another hand for that. Again, feel free to practice those skills as many times as you guys want, but I'm going to continue on and show you as our next activity, which is going to be bubbles. So once you guys are done with the balls, you can get out your bubbles if you have them. And if you don't worry at all because I have some for you, okay? So if you guys don't have your bubbles here, or even if you do, I'm going to send you some virtual bubbles too, okay? So once you guys are through playing with your balls and you've unpaused this video and you're ready to keep going, let's get our bubbles out, okay? You guys can put on some music if you would like with our bubbles. And let's go. Maybe play for just a few minutes, maybe a whole song, maybe two if your child really loves bubbles, but I'm gonna give you guys some bubbles too if you don't have any. Can you pop them? Maybe pop them with your hands. Pop them like this. Or use just your finger to pop them like this. Pop, pop, pop. Practice popping them with different body parts. Our toes, our feet are also good options. You can stomp on the bubbles, stomp, or just touch them with your toes. Go pop. Or maybe even your nose. That's also a really good one with our nose. Go pop, pop, but don't eat them. Awesome, everybody. That's all of the bubbles that I'm going to do today. But again, remember, you can play with the bubbles for as long as you guys would like. You can pause this video and come back to it at any time. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up class for us after we've played with the balls and the bubbles. So again, everyone, I know you guys miss the Little Gym of Sugarland. We miss you so much too, but we are very glad that we can have this class with you guys from the comfort of our own homes. And of course, being safe. That's the most important thing here. So we're glad you guys are all staying safe and healthy. We miss you so much. But stay tuned for our next Little Gym at Home class, okay? There's more fun to be had, don't worry, okay? And we'll have you guys back in the gym as soon as possible, and there's going to be so much more fun there too, okay? So thank you for being such great listeners and participators today. You guys were amazing. I'm super proud of everything that you worked on today. So let's keep up the hard work, okay? At home, you guys can feel free to practice those three skills that we did. We like to call those our POPs, or our personal outside practice. So you guys can practice your log rolls together. You can do some upside down activities, and maybe even do some more sit-ups. And then once you guys come back to our next class, you can let me know how that went, okay? I would love to hear about it. One more personal outside practice for you guys is to read. I'm sure you're all finding lots of creative and fun ways to stay busy while you're at home. So another one to do tonight is read your favorite book together, okay? That's a great one. Next week, we are going to be talking about animals, okay? So stay tuned for our next lesson that's going to be about animals. But for now, that's all I have for you guys. So it's time to play our drums. So can everybody get your drums out? Ready? Oh, everyone, please play your drums and sing along with me. everyone. Thanks so much for following along.